Imagine a coastline in the tropics or subtropics. What comes to mind is a coral reef and probably a sandy beach. But nearby, there's another ecosystem that's often overlooked, yet may be even more important to the health of the whole area. It's called a mangrove forest. Mangroves are trees and shrubs that cluster along coastlines, including bays, lagoons, and inlets. Living in or adjacent to the intertidal zone, they straddle two worlds. Here, the daily rhythm of the tides sets the pace. This ritual exposes the intricate roots of the red mangroves, which live closest to shore. It's easy to see why they've earned the nickname walking trees. The harsh conditions of the waves and salty water would kill most ordinary plants in a few hours. Yet the mangroves not only adapt, they create a sanctuary. An extraordinary range of creatures live in a mangrove forest. Some stay here full time. Others come to spawn. 3/4 of all tropical fish are born here. Beautiful and delicate organisms seek refuge. Countless reptiles and birds call these forests home. Other ecosystems nearby, like coral reefs, also depend on mangroves. They filter nutrients and toxins out of the water, improving water quality. Their dense, intertwining roots also provide protection and shelter during extreme weather. When storms, hurricanes, and tsunamis strike, it's mangrove forests that help reduce flooding and coastal erosion. Nothing made by man does it better. We've had to learn this lesson the hard way, because in the last 50 years, the world has lost more than a third of its mangrove forests. We've cleared them for coastal development, aquaculture, and lumber. Tragically, we've underestimated the value of this quiet, unflashy forest that turned out to be one of the most productive ecosystems on the planet. But it's not too late. We can still save our remaining mangrove forests and reclaim land for more. This vital ecosystem deserves our respect, and so do the creatures that call it home.